They passed their first test. The second round game, though, should prove to be more difficult between the Miami Hurricanes and the Auburn Tigers. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Tigers should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. First, don't let that big man become a factor offensively. Keep him off the block, push him away from the low box, and force him to shoot jump shots. Second of all, take care of the basketball. Turnovers can really kill any rhythm offensively. And finally, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Now trying to feed the low block. Tries for two.
That's Matador defense. Nobody coming over. Nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
Both teams looking to get things going here.
Nice fake.
Jump hook from the low block.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Golden pump fakes. Number 50 with the fake. Goes up for two.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
There's the screen up on top.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Down inside, jumps into the defender. They just can't seem to miss.
They found a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
York fakes the shot for two. Can't get the shot to drop. He keeps his dribble as they reset.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball in the deck. Where's he going?
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Misses the first. Hits the second. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
They work it around the perimeter. He makes the block. The Hurricanes are actually known more for their success on the football field more than anything else.
Hey, their football team is great, but their basketball program is starting to turn some heads.
Number 21 handles the feed. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
And now they'll bring it up. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, down here on the sidelines, I'm standing by the losing team's bench, and their coaching staff is reminding them it's just your nerves. Relax. Once you've settled in, you'll come back.
All right, thanks, Aaron. They're going to move it around the perimeter. Gave it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. entry pass in the and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. He keeps his dribble long enough to run his guy off the screen and slide in for the nice deuce.
Steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him and he lost possession.
They work the perimeter. The small forward handles the pass. Up and in. They go into the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Tries for two. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Takes away the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. Here's a double team. The dribble gives it up. He dials long distance, knocks it down.
At the end of the first half, these teams are all even.
It's been a tight one thus far, Mr. Vitale. What play do you think set the tone here tonight?
No bigger shot in the first half for me than this three ball from downtown, baby. Teams build the confidence they need when the threes are falling.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Is just getting punished in the rebounding department, Dick.
Hey, Brad, how many times have we heard that if you want to win basketball games, you have to control the glass? These guys know that. They better start getting the job done.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Jump hook from the low post. And in and out. Up fake. Goes up for two. The friendly bouncers aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
Both teams looking to get things going here. For two, way off target. Dumps it in. The power forward receives the ball. He tries the three ball. He buries it. For the deuce.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all have good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt.
No good. He pulls down the board. Gave it up for the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
And working around the perimeter on the dribble. Gives it up for two.
He used the screen perfectly to put it in the inside hoop.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish close position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
The point guard with the ball from three-point land. The ball goes out of bounds. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing, that leads you to the exit sign. No question, you get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over. This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
Too much. That's a foul. Let's check in with Erin Andrews, and she's got a score for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, this is what people wanted, a close championship game. The action and intensity has really picked up down here on the sidelines, and everyone wants to see a great finish.
Goes up for two. Poe collects the offensive board. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The center takes the feed. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Gave it up. Poe receives the pass. He shoots from the elbow.
Shot was no good, baby. Beautiful use of the screen, though. Great job getting back defensively.
He fouled him. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important. Oh, you got to knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
On the outside. On the dribble, gives it up. They'll work it around the arc. On the outside, the point guard takes the pass. For the bucket. Tickles the twine. Get ready to resume the action.
The lead is up to eight.
They could be starting to pull away here, Dick. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Up and inside.
The point guard gets the pass. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. That's a foul. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Gave it up. Cross court. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. A basket here will make this a two possession game.
Oh, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, try to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
6 points separating these two squads.
This is no time to get complacent, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the circle. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here?
They have the foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
I tell you what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
Second one is good. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Erin Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
Aaron's right about that. for something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
The lead is 6.
Hey, a tray here in this place will go absolutely bananas, Brad. I can feel it. Better foul quick.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Execution
goes home with the big W.
Kicks it out. In the paint. Tries for 2. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Dick, you said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Auburn is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.